हेलो पीपल, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। माय नेम इज अविरल एंड फाइनली आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ कोर्स ऑन एलटीएम डिजाइनर एंड दैट विल बी फोर लेयर पीसीबी डिजाइन फ्रॉम स्क्रैच। सो दिस वीडियो इज ऑल अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस होल कोर्स। एंड इफ आई स्क्रॉल डाउन यू कैन सी आई हैव डिवाइडेड, आई हैव जस्ट क्रिएटेड अ काइंड ऑफ टास्क दैट यूजली प्रोवाइड टू द डिजाइनर। सो हेयर द फर्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू स्टार्ट समथिंग फ्रॉम स्क्रैच। सो इन द टास्क इंट्रोडक्शन यू कैन सी the first thing is central controller part. So this is a kind of controller based board, and here these few things that we should include. The first one is controller should be STM32F407 and it should have its debugger which is STM32F103. So if you guys don't know what is debugger, to flash a controller we needed another controller, that is in our case it is 103, okay. And this board should have Ethernet connection. So to connect our Ethernet to this controller, we needed Ethernet fee. So we will use that. Another thing, it should have the USB 2.0 CAN bus and UART. So we will include those things and expose those using a connector. Another thing is, if you see here, they are asking for, it should have a 24-bit ADC. So what is the purpose of ADC? Generally controller has its own ADC, but they are including the external ADC because of higher resolution, I guess. So we have to make a circuit for analog to digital converter it can be connected either through some communication line. It can be UART, it can be I2C, whatever it is, right? So we will see what this controller is and how we can include that ADC in that controller, okay. Another thing they are asking is the controller board has the ability to run a two bidirectional motor. So we have to provide a connector, and they will connect the bidirectional motors, and it will run, obviously it's a bidirectional, so it will run on both sides, right? And here they are using DRV8701 motor driver with a MOSFET bridge, right? So they have given the driver and the topology that we're going to use to run the motor in both direction, right? So these are the minimum requirement of this board that we will going to design. And there are a lot of other things obviously to power up this board. That decision we will take by ourselves. So that is one thing. Okay, so finally I just want to discuss one more thing. What are the five non-technical things that we're going to learn in this video? The first one is how to create a pin map using a reference schematic. So whenever we design a schematic from scratch, so we are not like, this is very tricky part. Whenever we are designing something from scratch, we are basically using a design, not design, a schematic design as a reference. So right now you can see we are using STM32F407, right? So what we will do, we'll just pick a reference design which is already designed by someone. We will use it as a kind of base in our design, right? And using that base, we will create a kind of pin map on Excel or Word file, whatever you want. So we'll basically assign pins. For example, this STM has, it has two I2Cs, right? So one I2C we will expose on the communication interface, and another I2C will be communicating with the 24-bit ADC, right? So we will assign I2C1 or I2C2, which one is communicating with the ADC and which one is on the connector, right? Similarly, I mean, this is, for example, we can use a proper pin map for that, right? So we'll assign pin, like which analog to digital converter we are using, which suppose GPIO we are using for what purpose, right? So we can kind of reassign. We will not reassign that GPIO to another task. So we'll kind of create a pin map before going further. Another thing is how to choose component. So you can see there are a lot of components that we need to choose, like voltage regulators, clocks, discrete component, power switches, connectors and all, right? So we'll discuss how to choose those components for our schematic design as per our application. Now, the next part is how to use online available footprint and symbols. So, like, usually people ask why we need to create component from scratch, right? And that is correct. I mean, if it is already available on online, we can use them, right? So, what is the correct purpose of correct procedure of using those component in our design? That I will discuss there. Another thing is time management during the big design, right? So this will be a kind of 7 to 10 pages schematic. So I will discuss how to manage the time, because I'm going to design this whole board live, right? Because I'm recording those and publish them, right? I'm not designing it before, then recording, then publishing, because it will take a lot of time, right? So I'm kind of doing it live. So, how we can manage the time during the schematic and placement and layout, right? So it has like lot of, if I'll tell you a little bit, it has kind of iterations. So firstly, we don't think about anything. We just place the component as per schematic design, right? For example, there is a regulator. After that regulator, we are using a 10 microfarad capacitor. After that, we are using a 0.1. So we'll arrange them like that, right? Then later during the layout, we'll kind of rearrange the component placement, right? So it has few iterations. So I will tell you how we can manage the time during those iteration, right? Now, the next step is professional cycle design of manufacturing, right? So generally, like we get as a freelancer, we get projects from vendor or clients, right? So what is the right purpose? What is the right procedure of from designing to manufacturing? So firstly, what we'll do, we'll just create the component library. Either we are using online library or we are creating our own library, right? The next step will be schematic design. We'll design the schematic using that library. And the next step will be BOM. So after designing the schematic, we can generate the BOM, right? And the next step will be the order component. Generally, what we do, we just create the schematic, then we go for the placement and layout. In the last, we create the BOM, right? Because placing order of component will take time, because you have to choose the cheapest component available, or sometimes you have to replace the component with another component because the component you are using, it is so expensive, right? So if you provide BOM to client like in an earlier stage, he can give it to their like purchasing team or purchase by own, whatever he'll do. He'll just make the list and like tell you which component is so expensive. Please find the alternate part number for that, and you can do it in earlier stage. That is the main purpose of this whole cycle. The next step will be the placement and layout, and then you can give it for manufacturing. So when your PCB will be arrived, you already have all the components, right? So you can go for assembly and testing. So this is the whole thing that we're going to discuss in practical way, how we'll manage the things and how we'll create something from scratch. So right now you can see on screen, I have just this one page of information, and I'm going to create a whole schematic design and PCB from scratch. So this is the whole purpose of this series, and I hope you guys will like that. And if you guys didn't subscribe, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.